Stop the political bickering and deal with the water crisis. That is the advice coming from the leader of the National Green Party, Andrew Decaires. He has sounded a warning of a worsening problem being experienced not just here on island, but in many nations around the world.
The planet is experiencing longer spells of drought conditions and less precipitation during the rainy season. Although when we do get rain, we see enormous amounts of torrential rainfall in short periods of time, contributing to tremendous damage to livelihoods and infrastructure. This year's dry season has been quite severe and is reflected by the fact that we have all experienced water shortages at some time this year so far. Water shortages affects every aspect of life. When combined with a two-year pandemic that has caused a massive reduction in productivity and resulting in reduced production of all items, plus a hit to the essential supply chain that transports these goods globally, the impending disaster is imminent.
As food prices continue to increase, the calls are growing even louder for food security. That, however, cannot be achieved, says the NGP leader, without first addressing issues of water shortage. That is precisely why he says his party made water and food security the first priority in their manifesto.
I received a disturbing call from a young farmer on the East Coast yesterday, telling me that their irrigation pond has dried up for the first time ever and that the levels of the river nearby are the lowest ever seen. And as a result, he spends his entire day bucketing water just to keep his crops alive. I too am struggling to keep my crops going and I've had to reduce production as a result. Multiply this scenario by 1,000-fold, as all farmers must be experiencing this daunting situation. This means that water tables are falling and the capacity of water catchment areas are decreasing year after year, resulting in the reduction of the capacity for farmers to produce crops.
With serious scarcity problems in prospect, water has been identified by the United Nations as an urgent security issue. Water security has been included as part of the UN's 17 Sustainable Development Goals for 2030.
Since the passage of Hurricane Thomas over 10 years ago, which reduced the capacity of the dam by one-third, our only attempt to increase the water storage capacity of the island was to commence desilting just 2 years ago. Yet consider the amount of development that has taken place over the last 10 years in all sectors, whether it be construction, tourism, manufacturing or agriculture. They all require water, not to mention the super hygienic conditions required to tackle the pandemic, with everyone washing their hands much more than they ever did. Yet there's little or no conversation at all by any of the two traditional parties, or in fact anyone, regarding this dire situation. What is even of more concern is that large wheat producers like Russia, Ukraine and India have either reduced production due to war or are beginning to hoard because they too face a growing food crisis. Imagine Lucians living without bread.
The NGP has proposed solutions to tackle the water problems of the island, including the construction of micro dams, investing in a national desalination plant, as well as requiring hotels with beach access to install their own. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.